have a good and earnest friend whose life feels shattered at the moment because his wife, who is, great trouble, has now left him. I'm not talking about myself this time. My goodness, does he identify with me there? But he's in chaos. In the sense that specifically something that's so important to him is being changed beyond his control. What should he do? Should thank God for it. Thank you, God. You're doing something major that there's no way I could do or would do. It's beyond my control. And you're doing it. And he says to me, but, you know, thank God I've still got the kids. I couldn't cope otherwise. I'd just, in a sense, he said, I'd go to pieces. I think he meant very seriously. He would kill himself in such circumstances. And I reflected, of course, on my past situation of, by which I mean the past 7 or 8 years, of something like similar circumstances. And it's a great realization to me, which I'd like to bless him with, that no, we would not kill ourselves in such circumstances. We would still be striving to trust our Heavenly Father. Because your happiness and welfare in eternity does not turn on you keeping your children now. I don't mean you must lose them, and I haven't entirely lost mine, although at times I feel I've virtually lost her. I have felt that, you know, given the difficulties, don't necessarily get a good response from the kids. I've got another friend who's like that, who just sees the kids and they don't necessarily respond to him. I mean, youth doesn't. It's coping with its life, isn't it? Trying to cope. And in the modern world, that may well mean, you know, they're on their devices, not loving you particularly, not relating to you as you always hoped and dreamt. Now, if you're in need, this is a great cost. If you aren't in need, and I mean in the best way, not in need personally, that, you know, your needs are met by your utter focus on God and love of Him and trust of Him. If you aren't in need of your children to love you and to have them personally, but only wish to have them, and this is a bit much to say, for their benefit, but that is being cut across and stopped by the unhappy circumstance of the family breaking up. Did you know that's okay? In as far as you're trusting that it's actually God that rules, not your deserting wife, not the difficulties of the present situation. They are not ruling. They are a consequence that God is taking you through. And it is very hard for you to cope with this change, of course. But it is not desperate. You simply pass through it, and all things change. seems so desperately important because you're in it now. In 10 years' time will be scarcely a thought that you return to. Unless you hang on to it as the great tragedy of your life that somehow God allowed and he shouldn't have done. You know, you're going to get bitter and twisted. No way. You're going to trust him with all your heart. And just as when the wife went, you said, "Thank you, Lord. Didn't want her to go, but I'm going to trust you for it." You rule. Nothing else. I am your child. You are what matters to me. Not the wife, and I might say not the kids. It's you, Father, that matters to me. And of course I would rather the wife stayed and loved me again. And of course I would rather the kids were in my care, as somehow ideally one would want that in an ideal heavenly situation. But it's not. I'm in a classroom and I'm learning what you're teaching me. And I'm trusting you with all my heart. You are my God. I'm trusting in nothing else. I'm not trusting in my wife coming back. I'm not trusting in my children loving me to bits for my faith and goodness despite my predicament. I'm not trusting that they turn out in this lifetime even into being wonderful saints. God will do what is needed. That's what I'm trusting in. And I will do all I can to be godly in the circumstance that God has me living through to bless me and all that he loves. And his understanding is way worse. I mean, unbelievably beyond my grasp. All I have to do is love him and trust him. How do I trust him more? Not by saying, "Oh, I must trust him more," but simply by reviewing all the goodness he's been to me in the bigger picture of the tiny life that I've lived to date. In my case, 75 years. The billions of times he's provided everything I need for life, even here in the universe of uncertainty. How much more for life eternal in the heavenly host? So, no, it is not the case that if I lose my kids, as the phrase is given, God does not lose my kids. God does not lose my wife. He is all-powerful and all-loving, and he loves all that he has made. Why would he make it otherwise? And he is so able. It may take a long time in terms of the universe of uncertainty, but compared to the eternity of his presence and all the heavenly host, it's but a moment in time, and perhaps not even that, a memory that is quite happily no longer referred to because of the goodness of our heavenly dad and all heaven that he furnishes us with. So you will arise like a fire that burns all before it. You will be loving and kind and caring in the circumstance you find yourself, which is quite a surprise circumstance. And you'll be astonished at his presence and his love in you and through you, and all the blessings, just as Marshall is. Bless you, mate. Thank you, Dad.